We are back now with our morning exclusive, the first live interview with Jeopardy's three biggest champs before their showdown to determine once and for all who is the greatest of all time. We're going to speak with Ken Jennings, Brad Rutter, and James Holzhauer in just a moment. But first, a look at how they got here.
Jeopardy, the greatest of all time.
This is it. The epic primetime showdown Jeopardy fans have been waiting for. Finally answering that looming question, who is the greatest Jeopardy contestant of all time? A head-to-head-to-head battle featuring Jeopardy's all-time top money winners. Ken Jennings.
What are tortillas?
Tortillas, right.
Brad Rutter.
What is a tequila sunrise?
Yes.
And Jeopardy James Holzhauer.
What is Sarah Lawrence?
You got it right.
All duking it out for that coveted title and $1 million in cold hard cash. Jennings, famous for his record-breaking 74-game streak.
Ken, what's a nightstick?
Yes.
Being a nerd really pays off sometimes.
Rutter, the top money winner on any TV game show with $4.69 million in Jeopardy winnings.
What is me talk pretty one day?
And Holzhauer, who shook up the system last year, taking home over $2.4 million in just 32 games while hunting for daily doubles and betting big.
All of the chips, please.
So who does Jeopardy host Alex Trebek think will grab the title?
I have no idea. There are elements that favor each of the three guys. They didn't win all that money by accident.
All right, James, Ken, and Brad, join us now. Thanks for being here this morning. I'm a Jeopardy junkie, so this is very exciting for those of us who will be watching with bated breath to see who wins. I kind of summed it up like this. I think so. James is the fastest, Ken's the longest, Brad's got the biggest pot. So those are your superlatives. Who's going to win?
The murderer is in this room, Amy. Somebody at this table, I bet.
I think I saw James with the lead pipe.
Tell me how you prepare. I mean, obviously you guys have done your homework to get to where you are today, but how do you prepare to battle one another?
You know what I think is amazing about what Jeopardy put together here is ordinarily the thing about Jeopardy is you lose, you're done. But they've created a best of seven format. One of your coworkers, I won't say which one, cost me some money when he engineered one of the greatest Super Bowl upsets of all time. But he has said to me, in a best of seven, he's not sure they would have pulled that off. You know, this is really like designed to let the best contestant show it over kind of a larger scale.
All right. And that best contestant is?
Tune in to find
to
out.
To be announced on ABC.
Well, similar to football, you can go back and look at the tape of the competitors and see what their strengths and weaknesses are. And, there really aren't
so
any
you were
weaknesses
studying
with
tapes
these guys,
for
but,
this.
Not physical tapes anymore. But, there's things you can
the rewind watch. Button on
sure.
the DVR. So the buzzer. It's always about the buzzer rate. What are your strategies in terms of getting in fastest? Because you guys probably all know the answers to everything. It's who gets it in faster, right?
I feel like I'm used to being the fastest person on Jeopardy. And then I play Brad or I play James or, God forbid, I have to play both at once. And suddenly I'm like, wait, I feel like a regular person out here. Yeah, just incredibly daunting competition.
A regular person. I love that. So I guess you guys already know the questions. Are they at the same level as other games? Are they harder because you guys are the champs?
I would say that they definitely stepped them up a notch for this competition. So
right.
I think that's probably as much as I can say without violating NDAs and such.
So you two have played each other before. You've never played against James. So what was your strategy in getting ready for that?
Well, like Brad said, we could look at tape. This is the first time I've ever been on Jeopardy where I knew for months who I was going to watch. So I got very familiar with James by watching every game I could see. You went to see him in person, right?
I did, yeah. And that's one of the benefits of living in L.A. Oh,
I love that. So, I mean, how many hours did you all put in to prepare for this tournament?
Ooh, yeah.
I mean, Jeopardy, you're kind of preparing your whole life for, honestly.
Yeah.
Like, every time you learn something new, you just try to file it away. Might be useful one day.
Yeah, that's a great point, actually, because a lot of people think you just study for this stuff. You can't do it that way. Like, there is some stuff you can brush up on, but mostly it's just being curious about information and learning your whole life and having it stick somehow.
Makes sense. I know the real star for this tournament is our host, Alex Trebek, and I see those purple ribbons that you all are wearing for him and, of course, supporting him in his battle with pancreatic cancer. What has he meant to all of you, very, very quickly, just to wrap it up?
I mean, just watching my whole life, I feel like I've grown up watching Alex, and he's the closest thing my generation has to a Walter Cronkite, like a broadcaster who you just trust because he's in your home every night. It's amazing that he's still with us and that he's facing his health battles with such
Your support, I'm sure, and the country's support is helping him, and we're certainly in awe of him each and every day, and of you all as well. Ken and Brad and James, thank you all. We wish you the best of luck. And Jeopardy, the greatest of all time, begins tomorrow night at 8 p.m. Eastern, right here on ABC. Robin?
We cannot wait. Okay. Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.